In this video, we will talk about how economists modified the first version of the solo growth model to help create a new and better growth policy. We saw how Solo Growth Model 1 was developed. It relied entirely on capital as the source of growth in the economy. But we also saw that it did not really represent what was happening in the world. So now we're going to try to modify that model to represent the real world that we actually see. And hopefully that will impact how we design policy, and the new policy would help us grow the economy. Solo Growth Model 2 suggests that technology leads to economic growth. It is not how much capital you have, but more importantly, how productive that capital is. With technology, nations can produce more output with each input. In Solo Growth Model 1, we state that GDP is a function of capital, human capital. In Solo Model 2, we modify the equation as GDP is now a function of A, which is going to be technology, times our production function. A here is a scalar. It increases the productivity of all resources. It just makes everything more productive. And that's what we mean by technology. Technology allows you to take the same quantity of capital and make it more productive. We can use the production function to graph what we mean by this. Graphically, the production function with capital on the x-axis, real output on the y-axis, we know that in Solo Model 1 had a production function that increased at a decreasing rate. Once we implement technological improvements through A, it pushes our entire production function upwards. Our production increases for every level of capital. Instead of capital K producing Y1, it produces a higher output of Y2. That's how technology increases economic growth. And the reason that people love this model is because we don't run into the diminishing marginal productivity of capital anymore. We just continuously make the capital more productive. The problem is Solo Growth Model 2 assumes that changes in technology are exogenous. Exogenous here means from outside of the model. Where technology comes from is unexplained. So exogenous growth is growth that is independent of factors within the economy. One thing that we haven't understood or haven't explained is where does technology come from in this model? It just assumes that it shows up. And the reason that Solo Model 2 relies on this is because economists believe that technological progress often seems random and seems to be a function of luck. And assume technology is exogenous makes the theoretical model a little easier to solve, and that's why it was utilized. However, this model makes it more difficult to apply policy to grow the economy. Policymakers have to rely on luck or technology being provided from the outside. This actually influenced the development policies of the 1950s and the 1960s. We saw two types of aid. Actual capital goods were built with aid, and aid was given to developing countries to fund infrastructure and purchase technology improvements. As a result of these policies, some countries received billions in aid, and sadly are no better off today than they were in 1960. Some countries received almost no aid and have grown rapidly. Incomplete growth theory, faulty policy, and real-world observation led to a re-examination of the growth model. So our growth models do not apply. Giving people more capital in Solo Growth Model 1, or this idea of new technology just appearing in Solo Growth Model 2, do not lead to economic growth. And that's where we move on to the new growth theory model. In the next video, we will discuss modern growth theory, which is the theory that allows policymakers to help develop endogenous growth.